All alone in space, fighting because we got nothing better to do. After all, it's either that or death. I'm Arachne, and this is Tyrian 2000. Yeah, specifically this version. Because there's a bunch more missions and the previous ones got some reworks and balance changes. Also, this review is gonna be only for the main mode, the full story one. The other ones, like Arcade, use the same levels, just in a normal shoot-em-up style. With lives, game overs and such, there's gonna be plenty of games like that, don't need to do that here. Especially since even the story is told in a very neat fashion. You look at this game and see the episodes and think it's all gonna be a disconnected mess, but it's not. When you finish one of them, you are automatically starting the next one if you play the main story. Nice work right there, Eclipse Software. And the story itself is not that complicated. There's just more than you expect from this type of game. You are a normal freelance mercenary when your family and your best friend get murdered. Oh, well. You discover that something bad is going on Tyran, there's talk of war, and some skirmishes have already broken out. From there you'll discover conspiracies, betrayal, planet-ending schemes, and a cult that kills people with explosive fruit. Yeah, this title has a lot of humor, and good stuff too, since in the game you can collect these blue data cubes that give you a lot of reading material, they better not all be serious and drab. Fortunately not. But the structure of the main mode works like this. You get an in-game menu and from here you can read the story you have managed to collect. Then you look at data regarding the current ship you have. Under that, there's your upgrade system. Yeah, in this title you can get many different things for yourself and you get to keep them. I absolutely adore this. Look at the sheer breadth of options at display. Aside from buying new crafts, you get front and rear main weapons. Shields, those regenerate over time. Unlike your armor, you need to be lucky and find some metal in the levels themselves to repair that. Some side weapons that act of their own accord. And then, most importantly, the generator. This item will determine how many powerful weapons you can carry. If your generator is bad, you will drain energy fast and you will have to stop shooting until it recharges. You don't want to stop shooting in a game like this, or you're gonna get booty blaster real quick. Why is this important? Because you can save your progress anytime you're in this menu, just go into options and voila! Permanent progress for a very long title. This is great, actually I think it's amazing. It's exactly the perfect entry point for any person scared of the genre. There's three difficulty options and easy is the correct name of it for once, at least in the first two episodes. Then it becomes more and more hard, but gradually so. It's very well balanced and with a great sense of progress. The only spikes you'll get are for the end of episode bosses, since they are multi-phase, so that's fair. Also, Tyrian 2000 features the possibility to New Game Plus. If you start on easy and finish all 5 episodes, you get started again, but this time on normal, with everything you have equipped and all the credits you have accumulated until now. It's important because some enemies and levers are present only in harder difficulties, plus there's a bunch of new equipment you can get only in those, so if you like it and don't have anything else going on, keep playing. I found a very rare drop called Hot Dog in my playthrough, and that carried me over until the very end, at least regarding the front weapon. There's silly stuff like that in this game, quite fun and varied, lovely. Plus there's another type of cube you can find, red or orange, you decide how it looks. This might give you some new equipment, but there's repeats, so if you don't see anything new when you upgrade, don't fret, you just might already have it. Now let's get into the gameplay proper. You can choose to set up an old school controller, use the keyboard or your mouse. Personally, I prefer the mouse. You just move it around to move your ship. With the left button you shoot, right button you do alternative fire if you have an ammo-styled weapon. Middle button does a special if you have it. The ideal would be having the possibility to keep the left button pressed and concentrate on moving your ship around to avoid bullets. That goes with the generator from earlier. Oh, I see. So that's how technology works. But how are the levels themselves? Design-wise, they are pretty similar. There are some innovations, meaning you can't move into certain walls and you have to work out the labyrinth, but it doesn't happen often, maybe 3 times in the whole game. Otherwise, they do sport some ground obstacles in the style of having buildings that might shoot stuff and you have to destroy them. It's much more than what shoot-em-ups do usually and it's kind of amazing it's there. Especially since there's already a lot of effort in the backgrounds and animation of them. them, there's minimal repeats. You visit only a small part of a galaxy, a bunch of planets near Tyra mostly. And even with that, you go into different places in them, so there's lots of visual variety. But not only that, there's an astounding amount of enemies with unique looks and attacks. I can't even begin to describe them, I think there are around 100 of them, and surely more than 10 boss variations, all done in beautiful 90s pixel art. It looks absolutely gorgeous and everything is very nicely color coded. I can tell bullets from the background even when they are similar in looks, that's for a good reason. Distinction of depth. There are multiple layers that give that feel. Clouds are just below you when you're on planets, otherwise it's asteroids. Unlike clouds, those have to be destroyed or they're gonna hurt you. Makes sense to me. Another layer is the buildings if they are present. Those also might have machines that shoot at you for added danger. Plus the ground, it might be space, water, some terrain, or a mix of both. Even an underground magma tunnel. It's fantastic because the bullet goes above all of those layers, making it perfectly recognizable. Amazing care and understanding of the genre. And the music is also fantastic. We are listening to a great and smooth composition from two musicians. They made a sound mostly comprised of EDMs with some rock sounding tunes. I prefer to listen to the electronic scenes outside of the game, but the bat rock works in game, I guess. Don't get upset. Rock is one of my favorite genres, but also one of my least favorites when it gets really generic and I guess 90s American. Think Nickelback or stuff like that. Yeah, I like to listen to video game soundtracks while I work or clean or do stuff that takes a long time. If I listen to commercial music, I might start singing and get distracted. I know, I'm a silly man. So not my favorite soundtrack, but at least there was some good variety. I really wanna give Tyrion 2000 a fantastic and well-earned 10 out of 10. This game really converted me to shoot 'em ups. They need to have somebody doing promotion and it's gonna be me. This title is also free on GOG, go grab it now. Seriously, it can't get any better than having a free masterpiece. If you wanna see me play the games that I will review plus some extra stuff, catch me on Twitch at ArachneRetro. It's my natural habitat, you see? Until next time, ciao ciao!